Today we're going to talk about how to upgrade the firmware for the BigTree Tech TFT 24 version 1.1. Now I need to show you something on the display real quick here. So as you can see, there's a menu option. So I'm going to click on that and I'm going to go to Settings and then Info. And you can see the version here is already 1.1 for the TFT 24. And it's version 27. So I'm going to go back. And what we're going to do is we're going to actually upgrade the exact same one, only because I want to show you this and not have to downgrade it. So in order to do that, we need a SD card, preferably 8 gigabits. I'm going to place this inside my Rocketek over here. Now, keep in mind that no one is paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial, but I will place Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. So now we need to go over to the website. So on the website, you can see that there's a BigTree Tech touchscreen firmware. This is for a bunch of different touchscreens. So we're going to open this. And what you're going to do, which I've already done, is click Code. And then download zip. After you've done that, you'll go to your downloads folder, which I'll show you in just 2 seconds here. And inside your downloads folder, you'll see a unzipped version of this if you extract it that has all the information on it. Now, what you need to do is first right click on where it says copy to SD drive. So inside here, what they mean is copy the information that you're going to use. So our SD drive in this case is going to be our E drive. So I first have to find my TFT display. In this case, it's the BigTree Tech TFT 24 version 1.1.27.bin. And that's a mouthful, but what it's saying is this is the actual firmware for your particular display. And it's saying it's a binary file. That's what the bin means. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to send that to the E drive. Next, I'm going to change the display up a little bit. I'll go into here. Actually, I'm going to do the exact same thing, but we could do other ones, but the process is the same. So I'm going to click on the unified theme. I'm going to right click on our size for our TFT display. And I'm going to send that to the E drive as well. Then I'm going to go back up, and inside this folder, I'm going to go to Language Packs, and I'm going to be doing English. So I'm going to right click, and I'm going to send that to the drive. And then finally, there's one last thing that we have to pick in here, and that is the configuration file. So down here, you have config.ini. Now, there is another one. I'm not sure what that one's for because it's not real clear. But for now, we're just going to use this one. So I'm going to send it to the drive as well. So now that I'm done with that, I'm going to go over to the drive. And as you can see, these are the things we need to do the upgrade. So now I'm going to go into the config.ini, and you want to open this with Notepad++. So this is an outline of configurations that you can do for your display. So I'm going to scroll down and talk about a couple of things that are most common. Right here, we have the ability to adjust colors. So I like to do it. It's one of those things. You also have the primary language that you can set. Zero in my case is English, so I'm going to leave that alone, but you can set a secondary language apparently as well. Up here, you can set the baud rate. Now, you see why it's 5 right here? The baud rate is actually set to 115/200, but the speed of the normal build is going to be this. So we're going to use 6 just to simplify. So that way we don't have to worry about matching speeds unless we change it in the Marlin firmware. And then the status screen, you have the option to either enable it or disable it. In this case, let's have some fun and disable it. Then down here, we can set colors. So if you want to do like, we'll do brown, and then we'll try dark green for the background color. just to see if it works. I guess there's a font color as well and a bunch of things that you can pick from up here. So we'll leave that alone for now. There are other settings. You can change the angle of your display. There's stuff about, the terminal acknowledgement. For now, I'm going to leave that off. You can play with that on your own. You just need to change the number. And I don't want to go through every single setting, but I'll show you what happens in a moment. I just want to go through here and see if there's any other things that stick out. There is some stuff at the bottom that I want to show you. You can actually set it to default Marlin mode if you want, I think, in here, but seeing how you have a TFT display, you might as well use the TFT display. But at the very bottom, there's a couple of things you can set, like fan counts. Remember that this might be dependent on your Marlin firmware. And then you have extruder counts that you can set as well. Same thing goes as well with that, as well as with all the other things that you may have in Marlin. So I'm just going to jump to the bottom because there's a lot of information in here that you can read through, and I don't want to cover it all because this will take forever. But down here, at the very bottom, there's the option to add commands. So these are commands that you can send to your printer to check its status, like M119. But I would suggest not putting it in this list because you don't get responses back for these things. So if you're going to do something like bed leveling, you can set it to start here, but then you're going to have to actually manually type in the actual command to save it for your EEPROM. But they do have EEPROM save here, so it might work. It's just you won't get any feedback. So now that we're done with most of this, what I'm going to do is save it with the Control S. I'm going to close out of this file, and I'm going to take the card out and go over to the computer and install it. So I'm going to pop this out. I'm going to take the power down for a second. I'm going to take out the card, and I'm going to place it in its slot right here. And hopefully I've got it in the correct way. If not, I'll have to turn it. It looks like it's correct though. So I'm going to turn that over, and then I'm going to repower the system with 5 volts. Notice the jumper. So as you can see right now, it's saying the program files and the size, and it's doing an update. So it's going to count through this. Now, one of the things you're going to have to watch out for is that at the very end, it may ask you to touch a bunch of dots. My suggestion is using a tool like this to touch the dots so that you don't miss the dot with your finger because the capacitive sensor of your finger is a lot bigger, meaning that it'll sense the capacitivity of your finger. So now it's almost done. It's going to start loading logos. This may take a few moments. And remember, you can downgrade as well with GitHub. You have the ability to actually go backwards in firmware loads if you want as well. But in my previous tutorial that I did on hooking this up, one of the issues was the actual speed for a lot of people. They're at 115/200 because they didn't know to set it in the configuration file. So I thought I'd cover that to help you out. So now that it's almost there, I think we have a couple more to go. It will then probably prompt us to touch the display or maybe not, hopefully not. And as soon as that's finished, we'll actually have a display to work with. So I will show you where to tap because inside the menus there is an option to do it. So at least you get a demonstration of what to do. So now it's coming up. So once it's complete, pop out the drive. That way it won't try and upgrade every single time, but they have changed this so you can see occur. So it will not try and upgrade a second time, but it used to try every time. So Let's go to terminal settings so I can give you an idea of what you can do. If you want to check the G codes for the end stops, which are not connected, so they should all say triggered, we're going to go M119, and then we're going to say send. This will tell us what's going on with the board, like in Pronterface. Another thing we can do is we can send custom commands. Now, obviously, these won't work at the moment very well, but you can increase the list of commands that you want to send by editing that file that I was talking about. In addition to that, we'll know that the actual speed that we set up will be correct for the baud rate, which you can see right here. And notice how the actual display for the status has disappeared because I changed it and the color and everything else. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.